got Mr. Jeremy Clarkson with us, ladies and gentlemen. We couldn't be happier because, of course, he's one of the top talents on TV, a man who casts his wry eye over life whenever possible. But, my God, you're looking old. Well, actually, you're not looking too bad, but you came and you're giving off the aura of like you've given up, Jeremy. I think you've given up on life.
I'm old, and I can't sleep, and I'm just so tired all the time.
Do your legs ache a lot?
Yeah.
My legs ache all the time these days.
It's a constant down the back of my thighs, and then you lie with them up in the air, and then you wake up at 5 o'clock every morning, and then you think, I've got to go to bed earlier and earlier, and you give yourself jet lag. I'm on New York time living in England.
That's not a good thing.
No, going to bed at 9 o'clock at night.
What are we going to do about that, though? We need a. Have you cut down on the caffeine?
Oh, decaf now after 6 o'clock at night. That's how bad it is. You go into restaurants and you have decaf.
Can't you just.
Just the waiters.
Couldn't you just drink yourself into a stupor?
Tried that. I've tried everything, and I'm just waking up earlier and earlier and earlier. And, of course, the kids are now getting to that stage where they're waking up later and later and later.
Because how old are you? They're not that old, are they?
No, 7, 5, and 3, but they're just starting to get to that stage where they're starting to not get up early. I'm never going to see them.
Yeah.
I'm going completely different shifts.
But that's probably a good thing, isn't it?
No, I like seeing them. I'm rarely at home. I like to play with them. It's, oh, Daddy's tired. Daddy's always tired.
Oh,
though,
that's terrible. Because how old are you now? You're 51, is it?
I'm exactly the same age as you. Exactly the same age as you.
Yeah, but you see, I'm fighting it. I'm railing
against the dice of it. Your legs ache, and what do you do to get to sleep?
Well, you know exactly what I do to get to sleep.
Yeah, I do, actually. We've just been talking about that. While Macy Gray was on there, we were just discussing what a man has to do at 5 in the morning. You're a man, you're lying in bed. How do you get back to sleep again?
I swear by Pilates. A series of elaborate and very complicated stretching routines. And if my wife thinks something else is going on, she's wrong.
How does the bed always end up 6 feet further from the wall than when we went to sleep?
Once, I don't know if people have really been lying here, but once I was in bed with my wife and that particular exercise took place and we were in LA, she thought it was an earthquake. Had to tell her the truth. Jeremy Clarkson has got out for your Christmas pleasure, and this is the ideal last-minute gift, I would have thought. It's also, I mean, not just a last-minute gift, obviously.
You might want to buy it now.
You better. Clarkson's top 100 cars. Now, if anyone knows their car, it's Jeremy Clarkson. Mm. There's no doubt about that. Yeah. But the top 100, that's a hard list to compile, isn't it?
25 minutes easily to. I had a bit of a problem. It's easily the first 10, then it was quite tricky in the middle, then easy again at the end. Yeah. But the middle bit was all very difficult.
Now, you're not going to tell us, obviously. You have to buy the DVD if you want to find out what is Jeremy's worst car and Jeremy's best car. But it's a surprise, isn't it? It's a bit of a surprise.
I know what the best one is. I can guess now.
Go on then, what is it?
It's a Ferrari F something. The one...
Wrong. It was when I was in my 30s. But I'm older now.
Oh, but should you not have put on the DVD then Jeremy Clarkson's 100 best cars as voted for by a bloke on the downward slide?
that's basically it. Look at the picture on the front. There's a man who hasn't had enough sleep.
And what's terrifying as well is that was presumably the best picture in the bunch.
It did. They went through the whole... Now, they said, because they've been using pictures, because you get that. People ring you out and go, we need to get some new pictures of you. Why? Why do you need new pictures of me? Use those pictures you took 8 years ago.
Those ones 20 years ago were the best.
Even best. Look at me.
That one when I'm bending over backwards doing the limbo and my cheeks look nice.
They took new pictures and put it on the front. He's like, God,
you look nice in the back, though. Look at that picture there. You look like a heroic male lead in the back there. You're looking off into the middle distance. You look very handsome.
I'm asleep. I'm fast asleep. Yeah, fast asleep.
So this video, and also you smash things up in it again, don't you?
Yeah, I always smash things up.
That's something you should
do. We played basketballs with cars. You ever tried that?
Played what?
Bar skittles with cars.
So what, you have one car down the end?
You hang a car from a crane and then try and swing it into other cars. It's a really good game. If you're bored on a Saturday afternoon, it amuses the kids.
That does sound fantastic.
Yeah, it is.
So you always put a bit of effort into these videos. Yeah. I always admire that.
You have to stand in to do my column in the newspaper when I'm away doing it.
They haven't come when you're always off on your long holidays.
Yeah. I was in Europe the whole of the summer.
You were working.
I tell you why I can't send my column in.
Yeah.
Is because I can't work computers when I'm abroad. Have you ever tried to hook a computer into a foreign telephone system?
I have never had any problem. I even managed to file copy when I was working on a Scion organiser with a small portable fax from a hotel in Athens.
Yeah, but do you think how much you have to... You know they harmonise the currency. European currency...
This is falling very much on the deaf ears.
They've made the currency the same. Plug sockets are all different.
The Sunday Times,
so you can't plug it in. Can't plug in the phone thing.
Okay, here's what you do, Jeremy. This is as simple as this. Get the Sunday Times to buy you a Nokia Communicator. It's a phone which works on the global European network. It has a keyboard. You can write the fax on that and send it straight away.
But you'd have to read the instruction manual.
You would.
Real men never read instruction manuals.
I'll come with you.
That'll be fun.
I'll be your Batman.
In my bedroom. Having earthquakes.
Oh, can you imagine the two of us in a room? That would be just such a horrible sight.
It would be disgusting.
For a mate to come in and catch us with towels on.
With our Nokia communicators.
Plates full of old burger rinds. Whatever a burger rind is. Let's talk some more. We'll play some music. You like the popular music, though, don't you, Jeremy?
Do I like what?
Popular music.
Yes, I do. I like the modern beat combos. Well,
what's your favourite band at the moment?
Travis. It's a boring answer. I know that I should have thought of something.
Travis, you're a great
Travis,
band.
I can't.
We'll dig some Travis out to play you in a minute.
Playing Travis.
Travis are great.
Well,
is that okay?
I'd like to see you with the Travis Finn hairstyle.
I haven't seen them. I don't know what they look like. I don't know what I've just said. I could have just said something back. I could have just said I like Cliff.
Cliff is nice.
Cliff is very nice.
You got to like.
Doesn't
Cliff,
like me.
Doesn't he?
No.
I didn't know. Well, I wish you told before we booked you on the same show. You been rude about him in the past?
Well, the trouble is he inadvertently rude about people, and you don't. They remember what it is. They say,
see, that's why I'm always nice about people. Then I don't have to worry about
it. I was listening to you on the way down. You're always horrid about people until they get here, and then you're incredibly nice when we're here. Gosh, you're a really nice bloke.
Is it that transparent?
Yeah. Spot it. No, I've got a radio in my car and everything.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I can work there.
I apologise to everyone, ever.
Is Travis ready?
Yes.
No, he's always what are we having? Ready. Are we having Sing?
We're having Side, which was the last single they did.
Oh, I like this one. Fran Healy and Travis there. They're a terrific band, aren't they?
They are. They're very good, because they're happy, and yet he's got a miserable voice.
That's what you like, isn't it?
Yeah.
You want an upbeat ending, but you want it to sound a bit sad.
That's exactly what he offers me.
I think you've encapsulated existence right there.
Yeah. No, I like them. I don't know anything about them, but they're very good.
So next year, we can maybe look forward to Jeremy Clarkson's Top 100 happy-sounding bands with bands with a sad voice.
Yeah. I can't think of anyone else.
You must be running out of car ideas to do that.
That's the last one. I don't want any more.
We'll talk about that and many other things, Mr. Clarkson, after the news. ADH 91 FM, this is Radio 2 from the BBC. Who was that? That was Thin Lizzy, wasn't it?
It was Thin Lizzy.
Marvellous.
Best ever lyric.
That's the kind of...
They did the best ever lyric in any song.
OK, well, hold on. Let's give this a bit of a build-up. According to Mr. Jeremy Clarkson, the greatest lyric ever in any song ever written by any human being ever in the history of mankind.
Yeah. I'll stand by it. I'm going to tell you and you're going to go,
Which song?
Jailbreak. There's going to be a jailbreak somewhere in this town. That'll be the jail then, won't it, really? Yeah. If you stop and think about it. No point ringing Tesco's. There's going to be a jailbreak somewhere in this town.
Now that Jeremy's told us, I don't know we necessarily need to hear it.
No, I just told you. I did quote it accurately. He's saying I've got it wrong.
But you were being comical.
Here we go, Let's...
Tonight there's going to be a jailbreak somewhere in this town.
See?
But you were being sarcastic, you see.
That's what he said.
But you were being sarcastic. I thought you were genuine. I thought it was going to be something that inspired you or lifted you up.
The police are going to be, where are they going to be? Where shall we go if there's going to be a joke?
Poor old feeling it. But you're still, I see you're still championing the denims.
I bought these jeans the other day.
You're still there in the quo look.
No, look at my nose. I've got a little bit. No, honestly, I bought these jeans the other day. I don't know what's happened. There's no space for your... It's just
that, once again, I'm sorry to bring this to Jeremy.
I had to stop on the motorway coming down here to rearrange myself.
That's the thickening that goes on through middle age.
No, it's not down there.
It is all
it's
over.
It's just chopping me in half. It's no good. I've got to stop.
Well, you bought those twisted denim Levi ones. They're for the youngsters.
They're too thick somehow.
You know what you need at this age in your life? You know what you really need? You need something with an elasticated waist and a soft flannel head.
Up here, up to the nipples.
Ideally, you know what you should be wearing right now? Pyjama bottoms. You should be wearing pyjama bottoms under whatever trousers you wear, and the trousers should have the groin should be cut down by the knee.
But even you've gone for the tight look.
This wasn't tight when I bought it. I'm like, you know, I just grow to fill whatever space is available. I'm like a sponge.
There's none there.
Yeah, it's not a good thing, is it? What are you going to do, though? What are we going to do about our ageing process? Do you know who we should talk to? Sir Cliff is here now. If ever a man has aged fantastically well...
How on earth does he manage to stay so
trim? He's fit as a fiddle. He's got a great body on him. He plays tennis remarkably well still. He looks fantastic. And you look at the two of us. He's got 20 years on us.
I know.
And he looks like our son.
A bit like George Bush.
Yeah.
Who's taken over from his own son. He's older than his father.
He is, yeah.
Yeah. And even more stupid.
And curious, yeah, not as bright. But what's your regime like? Because, you know, we're going to have to make...
Well, I've started shooting.
What, proper shooting? Or
yeah,
shooting
no,
people?
Shooting. No, not people, not yet. Haven't hit a person yet. But no, that's quite good, because you stomp about in the countryside.
Jeremy, that isn't exercise. That's just a little walk and then you kill an animal. That's not exercise. That's just dealing with your peasant side. You're kind of like, you know, the savagery that lurks within.
Oh, it's quite good trying to get the kids into it. You come home with the pheasants and go, right, we're going to pluck these children. We're going to pluck these and then we're going to hang them. Or is it the other way around? I can't remember. Not very countrified. And then you just go, yeah, but then can we go and buy some shoes in Sloane Street? Why can't we buy pheasants in the supermarket? Why do you have to go and drive all the way to Leeds or wherever?
Do you actually enjoy killing things then?
Well, it's very difficult to eat things if you don't kill it first. You have to kill a cauliflower.
I know where you're going with that argument. I see what you're saying there. But you actually, do you enjoy thinking, there's a living, sentient being. I know what I'll do. I'll wipe it off the face of the earth.
No, I think I'm hungry. I'm hungry. I'm going to eat that.
Yeah.
I had an ortolan this year. Have you ever had one of those?
No. What is it, an ortolan?
It's the highest French delicacy you can have.
I've never even heard of it.
Okay, it's a bunting. All right? Now, you need to know about this. This is the French. It's banned in France, so they all do it. And you net them. It's a bird, a little tiny bird. And then you put it in a box, a black box, it's dark and it panics. And it eats this grain, okay? Because you put salt water in there. Yeah, salt water and some grain. And it gets fatter and fatter. Take it out, drown it in cognac. So it goes, and ingest the cognac, pluck it, 8 minutes in the grill, and then you eat it all. Beak, eyes, feet, bones, everything.
A lot.
Yeah.
That's me sat here, the vegetarian.
And was it nice?
Yeah, I was there. I was all ready to do the kind of British offended sense of, yeah, this is just, it was fantastic. It was just the best thing I've ever put in my mouth. And it takes you hours to get the bones all sort of chewed out. You know, you're masticating away there.
But nice, though. It tasted nice.
It's great. The camera's on. So I had 8 minutes to eat this thing. Making all those noises. And I was all ready to go, that's just disgusting and how French, we should nuke them. It's just brilliant.
Yeah.
I don't know what a bunting looks like, but, I'm going to catch one.
Who was
I'm going to get
first,
a fishing net this afternoon.
This is what always amazes me, though. You know, who first came up with the idea of doing that to
oysters?
Bunting?
Oysters are the ones that go, who looked at an oyster shell and went, that looks delicious, I'm just going to put that in my mouth. Who did that?
But at least that was just something there, because I figure if you were hungry enough, you'd try everything once. But to then go to the, you know, laborious, painstaking process of saying, OK, I'll put it in a small box, feed it a salt water grain, drown it in cognac. It's like, that's a cold and cynical mind.
Somebody sat there for a long time. There's another one that we found in Spain as well, where they eat these barnacles. And you have to abseil down these fantastically dangerous cliffs and then chisel away at this barnacle to get it off with these massive Atlantic rollers smashing into your back, and you're trying to keep an eye when the next one's coming and shinning up the rope and thinking, OK, here's a calm, but you go now, you chisel it off. For a barnacle? I mean, this is Spain. It's not like you're in Ethiopia where there's nothing else to eat. It's Spain. There's a vineyard up at the top.
But
cows and goats and EU subsidies pouring in.
Are they not the best barnacles you've ever tasted?
They are. Actually, they're called pejerreyes.
What's a barnacle taste like?
A bogey. Actually, they could just have eaten their own bogeys, actually. No, a sort of bogey in vinegar.
Yeah, well, that's not such a bad thought.
With conjunctivitis. It's actually, no, I quite enjoyed it. I quite enjoyed my barnacle.
Yeah, you're a disgusting human being. I've come to the conclusion. I used to like you, and you come on here now, you're talking about eating, chewing up birds whole. Get out. Just get out. Get out. You're an animal.
Now I'd eat myself. Now I like eating things.
Oh, well, we've discovered that, but can't you show a little restraint?
What's the matter with eating a barnacle?
Well,
I admit it's a bit
But what
stupid.
About when the baby barnacles come home and they can't find their mum?
You don't come home when you're a barnacle. You're there. You're born, you fast yourself to a rock or a ship, and that's it.
How do you know? How do you know, Clarkson? How do you know what goes on in the mind of a baby barnacle?
Barnacles don't come home from school with satchels.
Little barnacle
and
comes
homework.
Home in its school uniform, look around for mummy barnacle, can't see mummy barnacle, daddy barnacle's gone. What do they see? You hanging from a bit of rope with a chisel, knowing they're next. Imagine that.
Jonathan, you need to get out of London often.
What goes through the barnacle's mind?
They don't come home from school.
Well, you don't know that.
I do know that. There are no barnacle schools.
You don't know. They might be underneath the cage where we can't see the cave.
There are no bunting schools either, before anybody writes
little baby bunting. There's a whole song about a baby bunting.
What?
By Baby Bunting. Daddy's
that is
gone
not
hunting.
A song. It's Emma Bunting.
Oh, no, oh, you can eat her. In drown her in cognac, I wouldn't stop you. Let's have a song. That's Ryan Adams there. I didn't even realise what you were playing. What it was. I was so busy chatting with Jeremy here.
Ryan Adams.
Yeah, not Brian Adams.
Is that not Brian Adams? It didn't sound like Brian. When you said it was Brian, I thought you'd lying.
What it is, Jeremy, is all the names that could be for pop stars have actually been used up. It's official. So now they're giving them out again, but they're just taking one continent off each of them.
Yeah, it'd be Ryan Air.
So we've got Sir Cliff Richard on, but there's a new young guy called Liff Richard. He's out there. Yeah.
Liff Richard.
10 years' time, there'll be If Richard. It's just that's what they're doing. They're working down the names. Abba, no more. There's an airbag called Ba.
Or Baba.
Yeah, Ba, the first B silent. So Jeremy Clarkson is here. Basically, well, he's coming because he's a decent human being. He's a lovely, very funny man. We love having him on the show. But he's got the DVD out. This is why, essentially, he's got off his backside, drove all the way in from Chipping Norton, where he lives.
I did. And stopped on the way, as I've explained, to rearrange myself. No, it was an hour.
An hour drive. And what did you drive in? What are you driving around?
Well, a Range Rover.
You're in a Range Rover. Okay, and that's a good car for a big fella like you.
I love Range Rovers. There's a new Range Rover coming out. Can I talk about cars? Are we allowed to do that? There's a new Range Rover. It's so fantastic. It's so brilliant. I so want one.
They're British cars, aren't they, the Range Rover?
No, completely not.
All right.
Designed by the Germans, and then the Germans lost them.
All right. Well, that doesn't.
Now it's owned by Ford. God, it's so good. I saw it the other day and sat in it. I must have one of those, but I'm too mean.
I've got a Toyota Previa.
There's nowhere we can go with that.
Where's that in the top 100 cars?
Do you know it, isn't it? If I did the top 200,000 cars, it wouldn't be in.
You've got to be careful. They're fast.
They aren't fast.
They're fast cars.
I assure you they are. Is it the new Toyota?
I put my foot down. It would really surprise me.
The really good thing about those new Previas is you can have an accident in them. No need to repair them because no one will know. It's just a slightly odd styling.
That is kind.
It's the Alpha 156 in there.
What's that? It's a spaceship, isn't it?
No, the 166 is.
Oh, I like those.
Yeah, I like those. They're really good.
My Toyota Previa is silver.
Great.
Why have you got a Toyota Previa?
Because I need someone to put the kids in when we drive around. It's a nice car. It's got a leather seat and everything.
A leather seat? What are the others made of?
The other ones are made of like a Formica, but the leather seat is one they show you when you buy it. So have a look at that. It's leather, and they don't tell you about the ones out the back.
Made out of barnacles.
It's a cost-cutting exercise. There's barnacles underneath it, probably. Jeremy, it's always a pleasure having you on. I could spend all day talking to you. We have Sir Cliff Richard waiting.
I know. I'm amazed you said, could you just hang on till after the next Ryan Adams track? Because I thought, no, Sir Cliff's in the building. He's here. I can hardly keep him waiting.
We're building to him, and I'm very excited about having on.
I've got to go shopping.
What are you going to buy today?
I saw a painting the other day in an art gallery, but I was really, really drunk, so I can't quite remember where it was. So if anybody's got a really good painting of butterflies in their window in an art gallery, can you give me a call telling me where your gallery
is? That's the soft centre of the Clarkson. You don't realise it's there. He's an aesthete. He's out there. He sees a painting. He stops. Yes, he sobs publicly when he sees something which touches his feminine side, and he's not frightened to admit it.
That's it. So anyway, that's exactly it. I just can't remember where it was. I'm going to drive around Notting Hill all afternoon looking for this gallery.
Hunting for a picture of butterflies.
Yeah, it was really nice.
That sounds lovely. Are you sure you just didn't imagine it?
No, I could have done. When I woke up the next morning with a splitting headache.
Because you breathe in a lot of petrol fumes in your line of work. Jeremy Clarkson is leaving the building, ladies and gentlemen. Jeremy, thanks for coming in.
No, thanks for having me.
100 Top Cars is out now on DVD. Buy it for the sad pet man in your life.